Hello guys, Tim Duke here, and we are going to the post office or a collection point to get a package I ordered over the weekend, and yeah, it should be a good one. There we go, package is in the bag, and now it's time to head to the school. So good evening, Tim the Duke here, and in the morning I went to the post office to get a little special or something, and I ordered an iPod Classic 5th generation. Interesting. So I've never actually had an iPod Classic before. I had the first generation iPod Nano back in like 2006. It had 1 gigabyte of storage, so good for like 200 songs, and that was pretty amazing. And then the third generation iPod Nano, which was sort of the classic looking iPod. And then the iPod Touch after this. So this is a bit of a nostalgic trip for me because I haven't had one of these before. And yeah, it's got the black coloring, silver on the backside. It's in quite good condition, actually. It's not too bad. And it has the 30-pin connector and also a headphone jack on this side. So now we're going to have to load her up with some music, and let's see how that goes. Right now, so let's plug her in and see what the computer says, because the newer Macs don't have iTunes anymore. It's just like built into the Finder, so I'm not sure how it responds. I haven't plugged in an iPod into the Mac before. So there we go, the iPod is in working condition. I have all my songs on here. Focus. All the songs I want to listen to. And what I'm also going to do is I'm going to delete Spotify on all my devices for a week, and see what it's like using the iPod in 2021. So here we go. Delete app and delete app. All right, wish me luck. So I'm just about to leave to school, and I'm gonna have to leave the AirPods at home and take the wired pods instead. At least these won't run out of battery because it's -3 outside. Yep, here we go. This iPod is so old that the controls on the headphone don't work. I can't even change song. So alright, it's now a Tuesday, and I've been using the iPod for a couple of days now. And yeah, a couple of points I want to point out is that the lowest volume on the iPad, so if you scroll the volume like to the minimum, it's still very loud. So it's sort of to the point where you can't really use the headphones and study while listening to music, because the music is that loud, and it's just a bit too loud for my liking. But I've hooked it up to the AV system, so I'm running into my speaker setup using the 3.5mm. output, and it's very quick to play a song. So if you want to come home, turn on the speakers and pretty much just press play, and that's how easy it is. So there's no fiddling around with the AirPlay or Bluetooth or anything. It's always ready and good to go. Actually, I went home the other day and I remembered I have one of these. So let's see what's inside. So I think I purchased this back in 2008 or so, it says on the packaging. And I've used it for the iPod Nano, third generation, first generation, and also the iPod Touch, second generation. But I haven't actually used it for the other. So the one I have right now is the iPod Video, aka the fifth generation, and in the 30 gigs. I think it's a bit slimmer than the 60 and 80 or 160 gigs. So let's see. Back when packaging in Apple was pretty good and overkill. Voila. So I'm missing the remote. I have no idea where that is, considering this is 13 years old. There's the dock. And then we have all these. And nowadays, if you were to buy an adapter, it'd be one adapter for one iPod for like 25 euros. But back in the day, you got all these other ones that you don't need. So let's see, fifth generation, here we go. And it still has the plastic on it. So let's open this one up. And then put this one here. Time to play some music in the morning. Oh, no ei sitten. Niin, mitähän sitä tulee? Ei vissiin mitään. Ootanko se käynnistyy vielä? Mites kuunneltais? Green Data, no sitä kuunneltiin eilen, mistä tämä seuraava kappale. Vähän ACDC. No niin, pistänpä päälle. Ja tuolta vielä noin. Eikö helppoa? Eikö tosi helppoa? On. So what do you when you want to put new songs on this one? Because you can't just go onto Spotify and find some new songs. No, you have to go get a CD or rip it off the internet. But CDs cost like 15 to 20 euros here in Finland, and I'm not going to go put that kind of money. So what you do is you go to the library, you rent out, you borrow a CD, you rip it, and then you put it on here, like we did back in the olden days. So that's what I'm gonna go do now. And then there's the other problem that all the newer Macs or computers don't have CD drives. So I'm gonna go have to go back home, use my dad's old PC, put it onto the cloud, and then put it from there onto here.
Minus 17 degrees outside, that means I can use my Yoda hat.
All right, let's go find some CDs. There's the new museum. CDs. Alright, successful mission. I got 5 CDs for the price of 0 euros and got some popular music and got some Green Day and some classical music to study too. Alright, time to burn some CDs. We have Oblivion, some classical. We have Taylor Swift. Is this the. Yep, 1989. We have the Lover album. We have some newer Katy Perry. And we have some Revolution Radio from Green Day. All right, hopefully this baby has iTunes. Put the CD in the CD drive. Haven't done this in a long time. Close it up. So here we go. iTunes says, do I want to import this CD? And of course I do. So let's say yes. I consent. There we go. And now it's doing something. Yeah, it's taken a bit longer than I remembered, so I had to do something I didn't do when I was a kid. iTunes and beer. Hell yeah. So there we go. I've uploaded all the CDs to this computer and then uploaded all the music to my Google Drive folder, and I'm going to download the music from there onto my Mac at home so that I can sync using a Finder onto the iPod. So to make story short, this was 35 euros, very well spent. It's in really good condition. The battery life is pretty good still. It lasts for like maybe 4 days on my usage, 4 or 5 days, and I've really been enjoying the shuffle mode. So it shuffles all my favorite songs, which is something I sort of miss on Spotify because I don't have a big playlist. I should make one with all the same songs that I have on my iPod, and then I could just like shuffle that one. But yeah, that's something to do in the future. Yeah, I'll be keeping this docked up to my speakers in the future. And also the financial aspect that Spotify Premium in Finland is 11 euros a month, which makes it to like 130 euros a year. And then once you stop paying for it, you get the ads. So you sort of have to pay for Spotify for the rest of your life. And that's, when you think about it, quite expensive. And especially since I only listen to like a very small amount of songs, and those songs on repeat, it would make more sense for me to buy the CDs and then just have the music for the rest of my life and listen to it that way. All right, thanks for watching. Tutu Duke out, and see you in the next video.